The rising tide gushes like a washing machine. Here, swift water rescue crew teams are no use. Only helicopters can save them. Dozens are plucked to safety, but in the town of Grantham, scores remain missing. Or we crept into the neighbouring and larger town of Gatton to find a raging torrent.
This, I've never seen anything like this in my whole time of here.
A command post has been set up, but it's a dark hour.
Well, obviously a lot of people still to be found, and there's a process of looking for those people, and we've had some lucky escapes, and we've had some sad losses.
Here is why. Between Gatton and Grantham, major roads are destroyed. Part of somebody's home sits across this bridge. There are large sinkholes, trees have been jammed into the railing. The tower is lifted as if by a jackhammer.
We're on now, couple hundred metres to the approach here, you can actually hear the water running under the road.
Many of those in crisis accommodation just want to go home.
A nearly 81-year-old looking after a 3- and 4-year-old, which I'm very stressed about.
All are living their worst nightmare.
Other than that, snakes trying to get in through the doors. That was pretty scary. That's when we started to panic.
Come sunrise, the damage is staggering. We are the first to cross into Grantham, and this is what we find. There is an eerie silence. Cars, any number of them, litter crop fields. There are upturned trucks, houses are ruined, but we're forced to flee as the rain begins again.
On the other side of that road is now the deserted town of Grantham. We briefly made it to the other side before the heavens opened up and we were forced to flee. Police are pulling us out. They say they're going to have to do a full-scale search of the other town.
Jonathan Lee, 10 News.